2-1. Okay, Seer. Step in.
Be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken.
All because these words were spoken.
Harry?
Michael.
Oh, so good of you to visit.
I live. Never mind.
Oh, where's Mister?
Out for a bit. He'll be back.
Lazy bugger. Don't do that.
What?
The bed. That's Mister's job.
Just help me out a bit.
Well, no, don't. He gets paid to do that. Lazy bugger.
I know.
I'm going to tell the matron all about him. I'm going to tell her Mister is lazy. And mean.
Mean? Really?
Yes, Mister is lazy and mean. The last time he washed me, he...
Oh, let's sing, Mom. We were singing? Now, where were we? Be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken. All because these words were spoken.
I love you, yes I do, I love you.
Singing is the quickest way to win her back, especially if it's one of her longtime favorites from back in the day. Like a charm. Mm-hmm. How are you feeling? Am I comfortable?
Blooming fine!
That's what I want to hear.
My.
Yes, Ma.
Your hobby makes you so good at the funniest things.
Theater is my job, Ma.
Yeah, well, it's not a very good one.
I know.
You hardly get any work, and when you do...
Pay is so much less than Mistress.
Oh, put that down! There are dirty things in there.
I'm just getting it out of the way. The one pays a lot better. The jobs of hospital orderly and theater professional may have something in common. At times, they both tend to deal with a lot of shit. In case you haven't guessed already, incontinence is often part and parcel of your dementia experience. See, the room is all nice again, isn't it?
Yes, it is lovely. You're so good to me.
Yeah. While I wasn't always nice or... good to her, that is.
No, Ma. No one did that.
Yes, I'm telling you, yes. Somebody bought me a new house.
Do you even know where this place is, this so-called new house that some random stranger bought for you?
I'll know it when I see it. And it's not some random stranger.
You'll know it when you see it. Maybe I can help you find it.
I will find it. I know exactly what it looks like.
Okay, where is it? Who is this person who bought you this house?
It's none of your business.
It is!
It's not, so stop asking!
But it is my business. I wake up this morning, fix you breakfast, come in here, and you're gone. For the next 45 minutes, I'm running around looking for you, and you're half a mile away, dressed like that. It's a good thing the neighbor saw you. What's so funny?
Nothing. What's wrong with what I'm wearing?
I'll grant you, wearing adult diapers and little else is a bold fashion statement. I just don't think you're wrong. ready for that quite yet.
This was my best purse. You don't think it's nice?
It's a very nice purse.
I wore a hat. You don't think the hat is nice?
Forget the hat. Forget what you're wearing. Do you know how dangerous what you did is? I'm your primary caretaker. I would be in a lot of trouble if something, God forbid, should happen to you. So the point is, it is my business.
It's none of your business.
It is.
It's not. Now stop being so upset. Can I have some tea, please?
Here's some pudding.
Oh, good. Is Mr. gone?
Far, far away.
He never brings me pudding, but you do. This is vanilla.
That's what you asked for.
I asked for chocolate.
You asked for vanilla.
Chocolate. I want chocolate.
Are you sure you want chocolate?
This is vanilla. This isn't chocolate.
I know, but...
I want chocolate.
Okay, okay. I'll go get you the chocolate.
I waited for you that night.
Okay, here's the chocolate pudding.
Oh, I don't want any!
You just asked for chocolate pudding.
I did?
Yes, you did.
Oh, can I have vanilla instead? If you don't have vanilla, can I have Jell-O? Lime Jell-O would be so nice on this warm day.
No, no, you will not get pudding today, or Jell-O, or anything ever again! Okay, that wasn't entirely true. I never said that last line. I wanted to. In reality, I did much worse. Forgetfulness is forgiveness, eh? It can be pretty infuriating. Sometimes in my mind, dealing with Mum's dementia was like playing out the elusive plot of some film noir, in which she was the femme fatale and I was the hard-boiled detective. Listen, doll, you don't get this pudding until I hear about this house. You better sing, doll, or you can say grand adios to this pudding you want so bad. So let's have it. Croon me a tune. Spill it already.
Okay. It's a... Be sure it's true when you say I love ya.
Oh, wise ass, eh?
You did say sing, didn't ya?
Listen and listen good. I won't stop with the pudding. I got friends, you hear? The not-so-nice kind who can make sure that pudding disappears from this world forever. Yeah, I thought so. Now talk.
What flavor you got?
Huh?
The pudding, knucklehead.
Oh, vanilla. The fancy French kind.
I want chocolate.
You asked for vanilla.
I get chocolate and you get nothing from me.
Look, don't play me for a patsy. I've seen the song and dance before. I'll bring you the chocolate, you'll ask for the vanilla. You better square with me and square with me now. Where is this house and who bought it for
you? It ain't none of your beeswax.
That's where you're wrong, see? It's more of my business than you think it is.
Do you like my outfit?
What?
Do you think this ensemble works?
It's a little bold for my taste. Look, I didn't chase you halfway down the street so you could jerk me around with a second-grade cabaret routine. If I hadn't caught up with you in time, who knows where you would have ended up. So stop with the shenanigans and tell me, or...
Okay, it's...
Yeah?
It's...
Spill it, doll. Do it. I'll give you any flavor of any pudding you want. I'll even throw in all the Jell-O in the world. Lime Jell-O, the kind you like, because that's the kind of guy I am.
Not a very nice guy.
Don't worry your sweet head about that. Mister won't know a thing. Scout's on.
Okay. It's a sea to die.
Millions of words have been.
All because these words.
Millions of hearts.
All because these words were. Because these words were spoken. It's okay, Mom. It's okay. I'm here. I call those the low RAM days. The days where she wasn't quite lucid. Those became more frequent with each plateau she descended from. The current research calls them stages. I much prefer plateaus. Just as you get used to one, there's a dip and a brand new plateau to deal with. Never a dull moment. The low RAM days were never fun, but they're not to be confused with the instant rewind days. Good morning, Ma!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas?
Yes, Merry Christmas!
Ma, it's April!
Merry Christmas!
Of course it is. Merry Christmas, Ma.
Well, wait, I have a present for you! Now I just have to find it. I'm becoming so forgetful these days. It's here somewhere.
It's okay, Ma. Don't worry about it.
Here it is. I didn't have any wrapping paper. I hope you don't mind.
It's very nice. Thank you.
You will remember to write to me when you get there, won't you?
Am I going somewhere?
You will remember, won't you?
I'm going somewhere?
What? Oh, it's you, Mike. No, never mind. I don't know what I was thinking.
Then it's Christmas.
Yes, Christmas. Will we be having Christmas pie today?
Christmas pie? Yes, Christmas pie it'll be then.
Lovely.
Yeah, it was Christmas to her every day for 2 whole months. Heck, if that was her reality, it wasn't a bad one to be stuck in. Who was I to pull her out?
When will we be eating?
What? Oh, the Christmas pie. Well, if I start cooking now, about 2 or 3 hours.
Good. That gives me plenty of time to pick up something nice.
If you need help, just call me.
It's taking me so much longer to get ready these days. But I think I know just what I want.
Sweet extra well for 2 whole months. Not always Christmas pie. And I got presents every day. Apart from the ballpoint pen, I got nail clippers and a quarter. Pretty much anything she could find in her room. After a few days, I just wrapped something up and left it in her room so she'd have something to give.
Mike?
Yes, Mom?
Do you remember what I...
You were going to pick out something nice to wear for Christmas lunch.
Was I?
Come on, let me help you pick something.
Mister! Stop doing that! Why are you being so rough, you rude bugger? Stop doing that!
Let me help you with your room.
Wait! I can do it! I can do it! I told you I can do it. Mister, are you going to help me or not? Isn't that what you're paid for?
There you go.
Thank you.
Let's get you into bed now.
I don't want to.
Okay. What do you want to do? Do you want to stand here all day?
Not. Don't be stupid.
Well?
I want to sit by the window.
Feel all nice and fresh after your bath?
Yes. Fine.
All comfortable now?
Yes.
Good. I'm glad.
I
chocolate.
You always know exactly what to bring me. You won't tell Mister. He'll tell the matron and I'll get into trouble.
It'll be our little secret, I promise.
Are you playing with your friends out there?
Here you go.
You won't tell Mister.
My lips are sealed. Mister appeared around the time when she could no longer clean or bathe herself. This was a case of propriety ruling over dementia. In her mind, her son should never be tasked with these less than savory duties. So when I performed these duties, I became Mister. She had a long love-hate relationship with Mister.
Mister?
Yes?
I wanted to tell you, you look nice today.
Thank you.
No, really, very nice, very handsome. You don't mind if I say handsome, do you?
No, it's fine, thank you.
Do you have a girlfriend? A wife? I can't remember if you told me or not. But if you do, she's a very lucky person.
First time she treated me like an orderly in a hospital, I'll confess my ego is bruised pretty deeply. I wanted to be seen as her dutiful son, though once I figured it out, there was a strange comfort to it. At least this wasn't a plateau of anger. That was an earlier period that had me concerned that she would end her days bitter, spewing piss and vinegar. Almost every other day, she would bitch about something that happened to her in the past. Lies, deceit, betrayal. I would hear in great detail repeatedly how she had been
left out, lied to, put down.
The mother I grew up with was a pretty positive person. Sure, she had her moments, don't we all? But during this period, she knew that something was not quite right with her. She was trying to hold on, desperately trying hard to remember.
How dare he? How dare she? How dare they?
But she could only recall the bad things that happened in her life. And when she wasn't angry over some past injury inflicted on her, there was also the paranoia.
I've been wrong! I've been cheated. They want to get me.
That I attributed to her strict upbringing as a Catholic, maybe.
Shh. They're watching. They're listening. They're coming to get me.
Shh. That I attribute to a high security clearance job she had with the government. I can assure you, though, even through long-term memory episodes being relived, state secrets were never revealed or compromised.
Why did he have to insult me in front of them?
What is it, Ma? What's wrong?
He said I didn't want to marry your father. He said I wouldn't have married him if...
If what?
Nothing.
But that party happened over 20 years ago.
It still annoys me.
Oh, she was more than annoying. And I never really did get to hear the end of that story. Soon after, she descended into another plateau. In a way, this new plateau was easier to deal with than the angry plateau. Sure, stories were still repeated, but the angry ones faded away. Although it did hold its own challenges, at least for me, personally. Ma! Ma, what's wrong? It's okay. Okay. Were we having a bad dream?
Who are you? What are you doing in my room?
Ma, it's me! Michael!
I don't know any Mike!
Ma!
Stop calling me that! I'm not your mom! Get out! I'm not your mother! I don't have any children! I don't have a son! Get out!
It's never easy when they don't recognize you. Your parents created you, and if they don't know who you are, then your entire existence comes into question. I got over it. Okay, truth be told, I got over myself. It didn't happen very often, and when it did, if she didn't recognize me as me, she recognized me as someone else.
Harry, is that you?
Yes, Julie. Oh.
Sometimes I was my own dad.
Papa?
Sometimes I was her father.
How's my little working today?
Sam! Sammy!
Or her brother. But then this happened.
Max, is that you?
She always called for this Max in a whisper. Yes, it's me, Chili.
You're not Max!
Okay, my theater improv training and now prepare me for this. With my dad, her father, and brother, I had a point of reference, a change of voice, nicknames, but I had nothing for this Max. And I couldn't just make something up. Well, I could, and I did, but she never really responded. For all I know, this Max could have been female.
Mike?
Yes, Mike?
Where's Harry?
You mean... Dad?
Yes, where is he?
Mike, he passed away.
Oh. What? How?
He was sick.
He was sick?
Yes. We had all gone on holiday by the seaside, and he got sick.
I remember the seaside, but I don't remember that.
Well, he was very sick.
He was?
Yes, but you saw us through that. You saw us through everything, even after he passed away.
When did this happen?
A long time ago, Mom.
When, exactly?
About 25 years ago.
Really?
Yes. Oh. I made that mistake a couple times. It was heartbreaking having her process this news over and over again as if it were for the first time.
He died, really?
Yes, Mom did.
Was I at the funeral?
Yes, we were there.
I was there.
Yes.
Why can't I remember this?
It's okay, Mom.
No. No, it's not. It's not.
So I lied after that.
Mike?
Yes, Mom.
Well, where's Harry? Where's your father?
He's still at work.
Oh, yeah, he's working today.
Yes, he should be home soon.
Oh, good.
See what I mean? She would have forgotten within 5 or 10 minutes anyway. I hated lying to her, but it was better than seeing her mourning over and over again. It seems more and more, with each descending plateau, short-term memory shrunk and long-term memory expanded. Sometimes it played out in the most wondrous episodes. Ma! Ma, where are you?
Mama's not here, Sam.
Oh. Where is she, Jilly?
She went to market.
Where are you?
Bet you can't find me.
Bet I can.
No, you can't, pee-pee head.
Yeah, I actually met her once as a 10-year-old tomboy. So some cultures still call her condition the second childhood. I can see why. I actually prefer that. Alzheimer's and dementia sound so dire, especially to me. Pee-pee head. You can't call me that.
Yes, I can. And I can climb a tree higher and faster than you. And if you can't catch me, you're a big old peepee head.
Oh, you're in trouble now.
What time is it?
Nearly 3.
Only 2 more hours to go. I'm nearly ready. I won't be late.
For what?
The wedding.
Who's getting married?
Me!
Oh, of course.
Why are you being so silly, Papa?
Oh, you know me, I was just...
How do I look? Blooming fine?
Better than blooming fine. You look beautiful, Jilly.
Really, Papa? I'll always be your little orchid, won't I, Papa?
Always. Always my little orchid.
That was the first time I met her on the afternoon of a wedding. There was this glow about her, so happy and excited to face this new future. She really did look beautiful. It was a little surreal meeting your parent on the afternoon of their wedding before you even a glimmer in their eye.
Papa?
Yes, Jilly?
You like Harry, don't you?
I...
Oh, of course you do. Now it's me who's being silly.
Why do you ask? Are you having doubts about Harry?
No. I love Harry. But you wouldn't have sent him after me the other night if you didn't like him, right?
What?
Oh, I know it was you who sent after him, Papa. I'm glad you like him. I'm gonna go see Mama now. Something borrowed. I don't have that yet.
Wait, what? With most of her episodes, I can kind of link it to something in her past, at least in a vague and reasonable way. For instance, the house. It probably came from the fact that Mom and Dad never owned a house together. Perhaps there were promises that were made that were ever kept, at least in her mind. And the next day, this happens. Ma, I cannot find your ID or social security card anywhere. We need that today. Where did you hide it this time?
Oh, it's not in the usual place?
No, just like the last two times you hid them.
Oh, I don't know where they are.
Let me go check the garbage.
The garbage?
Yes, because that's where I found it the last time.
How on earth did they get in there?
Found it, just as I thought. Ma!
Man. Why did you do that?
Do what?
The garbage can is full of old family photos, all cut up. Most of them of Dad. Why did you do that?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I wanted to, okay? They were mine.
No, it's not okay. They were mine too, our memories as a family.
I cut him out of the pictures because I don't want to remember anymore. Now leave me alone.
I managed to salvage most of them. This got me thinking about things that had happened in the past that didn't really make sense. Things I had passed off and tossed into the I don't know what's going on there box.
You will remember to write to me when you get there, won't you? What? Oh, it's you, Mike. No, never mind.
And this?
He said I didn't want to marry your father. He said I wouldn't have married him if...
And this?
Oh, I love Harry. But you wouldn't have sent him after me the other night if you didn't like him, would you?
And maybe I was all wrong about the house. It would crop up again and again. And whenever I would ask her about it, she would always say...
It's none of your business.
If it was Dad, she would have said so. In the back of my mind, there was always the enigma that was... Obviously, there was something I was missing out on. What if this Max, at one time, had promised to buy her a house? One of those pictures was of the three of us at the circus when I was about four. Apparently, my parents had lost me to Justin Brown. Panic ensued, and they nearly went out of their minds looking for me. They finally found me in an elephant shelter, swaying to and fro in time with a baby elephant. For the first time in my life, I think I know how they felt, frantically turning over gory scenarios in their minds while desperately looking.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you're about to experience the most dangerous show on earth. Join us for a journey with Mike into uncharted territory. Welcome to Further Adventures in Dementia!
No, I wasn't having a psychotic episode. This was just my fertile theater imagination kicking into overdrive again.
So far, you've witnessed snippets and episodes of the last 3 to 5 years of his mother's life. Snippets and episodes of the selective kind, exclusively cherry-picked for your consumption!
Well, that was by design.
Design, you say?
Yes, design. The point was to illuminate certain moments of my mother's life that held clues to an event that nobody but she knew about.
That's quaint.
Quaint?
Yes, quaint. What about the mundane, day-to-day drudgery, frustration, and loneliness of becoming a primary caretaker?
Well, not all of it was drudgery.
What he conveniently left out was his reluctance, nay, his refusal to deal with her malady, especially in the early stages, effectively leaving her to fend for herself, while he wished it would all just simply go away. shall I go on?
Well, I was...
Or how he resented the inconvenient responsibility of becoming a primary caretaker because he was an only child and had no siblings to pawn her off on. And all of this heaped on his shoulders in the creative prime of his life, giving up everything to care for her where opportunities faded one by one until there were none. Do you deny that? Do you deny that?
Anyone faced with a similar situation would do the same.
True. And some never get out of it. But you still haven't answered the question. Well?
No, I don't deny.
Lovely. And now that we've provided these nice people with a more complete picture of what happened, we can continue on with the story. All compliments of this interruption and courtesy of your strange theater mind. You may now carry on with your quaint little story.
Quaint?
Carry on!
My theater mind can be such a brutal bitch sometimes, but it's an honest one. And if you thought that was surreal, I had to turn this off. Hello? Yes, a little after 2. No, I'll take care of that when I get back. Yes, call me when you can.
Great.
Who's that?
The cleaner. She's coming tomorrow afternoon. I told her to stay a little longer. I got some extra errands to run.
Oh, I can be here on my own. You go do what you need to do.
Ma!
What? I don't want a stranger here.
She's not a stranger. Lily's been our cleaner for the past 2 years.
You say I know her?
Yes, last week she brought you banana nut bread.
Lily, I don't remember.
You will when you see her. She said she's going to bring you cookies tomorrow. Look, I'll stay until you remember her, okay?
But my...
Look, I would just feel much better if someone was here with you. And I won't be out for very long, I promise.
Okay.
Do we need a fresh one?
No, I'm fine. Mike?
Yes, Mom.
Can we sing?
Sure. What would you like to sing?
You pick something.
Okay. Be sure it's true when you say...
There's something else.
Something else. Who's sorry now? Who's sorry now? Whose heart is aching for breaking his vow? Who's crying too? Who's sighing true? Just like I cried over. You don't like that one either?
I do, but it's such a sad song. Can we sing something happy?
Happy song.
Do you remember how the words go?
It's been a long time since I heard that one, Ma. When I grow too old to dream, I'll have you to remember. That's it. And when I grow too old to dream, your love will live in my heart.
Dance with me.
What? Now?
Yes, dance with me.
And where were we?
So kiss me, my sweet, and so let us part. And when I grow too old to dream, your love will live in my heart. Can we dance some more?
When I grow too old to dream, I'll have you to... Sorry. Hello, yes, hold on for a second. I'll be right back. We can dance some more when I get back. I promise.
Okay. I didn't know until that morning. That morning on the edge of the forest road, you asked me if you could have this dance. And then you sang to me. You sang to me while we danced in the early morning mist. Oh, there you are!
I said I'd be back.
Yes, you did. You kept your promise. I'm glad you did.
Are you all tired out from all the dancing?
Come. Come lie with me. Come. Come. Come here. Be with me, Max.
You sleep well. Yes, sleep well. Good night. What else can I say? Surreal. Awkward doesn't even begin to cover it. Okay, it was weird. Obviously, between the time I left and came back in her mind, I went from being me to this Max. So who was this Max? Was Max before Dad? Was Max after Dad? Several dozen scenarios flashed through my mind. There was one that stuck, though, in a Casablanca kind of way. Only this time it was my dad who was the Rick character, and Mum was Ilsa.
Goodbye, Max. Write to me, or don't.
Interesting place to trip the life fantastic. Not my first choice, but I'm not in this dance, am I?
So, you heard that?
Yeah. This Max guy's got a decent voice, I'll give him that. Could have been straight out of a Fred Astaire flick with not quite the happy ending.
So, who's sent after you? Papa?
He's got a lot on the line. Weddings are expensive, and it's the bride's dad who picks up the tab, so yeah, he called me.
Is that the reason he sent you?
Look, 2 days before the wedding and you take off at 3 a.m. Let's just say he was worried about his little work.
So, I guess you want to call it off then?
That depends.
On what?
On you, and what you want.
Is that it? Is that all you have to say?
Oh, there's plenty I can say. I could spin an airtight case for you to be with me, but that wouldn't amount to all the sand in the Sahara if you're not sure.
I came to say goodbye.
I saw that. What I didn't see was why.
Does why really matter? The only two standing here are you and me.
Are you and I standing here because this Max guy made a decision?
It wasn't his decision to make. It was mine. And I've made it.
Why? Because I'm a stand-up guy who can provide 3 square meals a day and who your old man likes?
That's part of it. A small part.
What's the bigger part?
Let's just say I like your dance steps better.
Not too crazy about my singing, huh?
It's decent. Your voice carries a tune. But what I'm a real sucker for is a good dance partner. So tell me, do I do this foxtrot solo? Or do I have company for the trek back?
You know, I think this is the beginning of a beautiful slow dance. Even if I was partial to that scenario, I still didn't really know for sure who this Max was. That soon became very inconsequential because all too sudden she fell down the next plateau. And when I say fell, I mean fell.
Mike! Mike!
It happened early in the morning when I thought she would still be in bed, it'll be safe to be out running errands.
Mike, it's happened again. Oh, Mike, so good of you to come.
Yo. Oh, we can do this. We've done this before. What were you doing in the kitchen? I told you I'd fix you breakfast when I got back.
I was hungry. I couldn't wait.
You rest, relax. You'll be back up again in no time.
Everything's spinning.
It is?
Yes. I don't think I can sweep the driveway today.
Don't worry about sweeping the driveway. You rest. I'll take care of that.
Oh, but you're so busy.
I'll see to it, my promise.
I just want to be useful.
I know, and you are, but today you're going to take the day off.
Why?
Because it's a holiday.
A holiday? I like holidays.
Yes. Good. Then you just rest and relax.
Oh, can we go swimming? I don't know where my swimsuit is.
No swimming today. You just rest.
Oh, can we go swimming tomorrow, Papa?
Yes, of course. Tomorrow will be better. Tomorrow will be blooming fine.
Am I still your little orchid?
Always. Always my little orchid. Sweeping the driveway became an obsession, mostly because she would forget. She once swept the driveway 17 times in one day. If there was an award, we would have won cleanest driveway on the block. I didn't know it then, but her dancing days were done. The fall had knocked her equilibrium out of whack. So now, dealing with her being bedridden was a whole new adjustment for both of us.
Show me the way to go.
Oh, but we could still sing.
I'm tired and I wanna go to bed.
I had a little drink about an hour ago, and it's gone right through my head. Wherever I may roam,
on land or here I go, you will always hear me.
Show me the way to go home. Would you like some pudding, Mom?
Yes.
Yes? What flavor?
Vanilla.
No. Low REM days were back more often than not. They manifested in various ways. What I called gurgle speak was one. After a while, you could kind of figure it out.
Pudding.
Pudding. Yes, the Nell pudding coming right up. Oh, what's wrong?
Ants.
Ants? I don't see them. Oh, yes, 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 there they are. You point and I'll brush them away, okay? Are they all gone now?
Thank you.
You're welcome. You want your pudding?
Later.
Later. Okay, I'll leave it right here for when you want. A concerned friend once asked what it was like. I said it was like dealing with a chronic drunk. The difference being, she can't help it. Her gurgle speak would come and go and altered realities flowed in and out more fluidly now. The biggest challenge during this period was washing and cleaning her in bed. I got pretty good at it. Or should I say, Mr. did.
Are you done, Mr.?
Yep, all done.
You are much better today.
Thank you.
Not so rough.
I'm glad. You feeling fresher?
Yes, thank you. I'm going to tell the matron you've improved. I'm going to tell her to give you better marks for your work.
I appreciate that.
Are you going now?
I'm going to get rid of the dirty bag.
And then you're leaving.
Your son will be here soon. I'm sure he'll have a nice snack for you.
You know about the snack?
Don't worry, I won't tell Matron.
You know my son?
I run into him in The hallways.
He thinks I don't know.
What? Doesn't he know?
He tells me this is my room. But I know this. This is a hospital.
What makes you say this is a hospital?
You!
Me?
Yeah, we work there, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
See, I know, I'm not stupid.
Yes, very percent.
But don't tell him I know. They did a very good job. This looks just like my room. I know, this is a hospital. Do you know what I'm sick with? Dizzy spells. I think I have dizzy spells.
Yes, that's probably it.
He thinks he knows everything, my son. He's a good boy. But there's something else that I know that he doesn't.
What's that?
You can keep a secret?
Sure.
Promise?
Cross my heart.
Max.
Yes?
You won't tell. Because if you tell, I'm going to tell the matron that you're rough with me.
Okay, it's up to you.
And what?
You were going to tell me.
I forgot.
You were going to tell me about Max.
Who told you about Max?
You did. You were going to tell me about Max to not tell your son.
Max.
And what about Max?
Max is his father. But don't tell, okay? You better go now, or you're going to get into trouble, I mean.
At that moment, I didn't know what to feel more betrayed about. The revelation of Max, or that she told a perfect stranger. You know, I was Mr. But still, Max was my father. Still, I had little time to worry about that. Being bedridden, her decline went from gradual to steep very quickly. Soon, she couldn't even feed herself. There you go. Last one. Is that good? You want some more? Okay. Let's get you all cleaned up now.
Not you.
Not me.
Mr. Peavy.
You want Mr. to clean you? Okay, I'll go get Mr. She's singing again.
Mr.
Yes, it's me. Okay, let's get you all cleaned up so you feel all fresh again. Better? All good again now?
Blooming fine.
Blooming fine. Okay. Let's check. Make sure everything else is okay. Just want to check to make sure. Okay. Looks like you're all fine. No need for change right now.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You are a good man.
I'm a good man?
Yes.
Thank you.
You are so good to me.
I'm so good to you.
Mike.
You want me to get Mike?
No.
Go get Mike.
You are Mike.
I am Mike?
My son. My handsome son.
You know all along?
Sometimes.
Okay. You're all cleaned up. You had your snack. What do you want to do now?
Sing.
When I grow to...
Not that one.
Not that song?
No. That was his.
That was his song. That was the song that Axe sang to you?
You look like him.
I look like him.
Handsome.
Who is Max? Is there something there? This is Max?
Max and me.
It was a picture of a happy couple holding hands on a beach. The young woman in the picture was my mum. And on the back of the photo, it said, Max and Lulu by the seaside. It turns out Max was Harry. My dad. Apparently my parents had pet nicknames for each other. Max and Lulu. It was the only photograph of them together that survives intact. That was the last time we sung together. Those 3 years were a challenge. I started out regretting it, and by the end, I considered it a privileged part of life. My mother lived an ordinary life sprinkled with extraordinary moments, like all of us. Even towards the end, when she seemed absent, she was always there. 3 days later, on a cool morning in June, I left a CD of her favorite songs playing, and I went out to sweep the driveway. When I came back, she was gone.
When I go to Rome to dream, I had you to remember. When I grow too old to dream, your love will live in my heart.
Thank you, everybody.
So kiss me, my sweet, and so let us part. And when I grow too old to dream, your love will live in my heart.